Hi everyone, I'm Mary with Mary Greeley News. Thank you for joining me. They are so lucky there in the area of the South Loyalty Islands after this magnitude 7.7 earthquake that there wasn't a huge tsunami that was created such as what happened in Indonesia in 2004 and Japan where they had the meltdown of the Fukushima nuclear power plants. There's been, I believe, 62 earthquakes so far in the last 24 hours. And it's what they call a finite earthquake, where multiple faults rupture all at the same time. On a page with USGS, they have information about finite faults. They have 12 earthquakes listed for 1 year, an entire year of these finite earthquakes. Most of them are fairly large. There is one that was not as large, a 6.5, Chalice, Idaho. That's interesting, gives me something to look into and more to learn about. That was March 31st of last year, 2020. Another paper that I found about finite faults, it says many studies have shown that small static stress changes do to permanent fault displacement can alter the likelihood of earthquakes on nearby faults. Many are very concerned about this recent swarm of earthquakes. Martin from the UK called me last night. Here's a picture of Martin that he sent me to me along with his daughter. Yeah, I've known them for a while. Great people. And we talked about the possibility of another very large earthquake coming, and it could. My thought is that because of the direction of this plate that I got drawn out in white, and the movement of this plate. Now, this plate was originally part of Australia that broke off and is subducting. That the Fiji Islands will be the next area to have a significant earthquake. To the northeast here, we got the Pacific plate, which, as you know, is being slowly shrunk and compressed. And this very well could increase the chances of an earthquake on the west coast of the U.S. So Fiji next. That's my guess. That's my own personal opinion. But the Hebrides Trench goes all the way up towards the Solomon Islands. And then we got these other microplates, which connect into Papua New Guinea. And we have the movement of the Australian plate down here on the bottom to the south. And then the Pacific plate up here towards the east. And you can see the arrows, the movement of that Pacific plate. And I want to go to Sumatra, Indonesia, where there was another very large earthquake back in 2004. That was a magnitude 9.1. That earthquake too was a finite earthquake. It was caused by the subduction of the Indian plate going underneath the Burma plate. And I think many of you will remember that huge tsunami that killed so many people. For some reason, YouTube didn't like the reports about what had happened there in the earthquake, and YouTube censored my videos back then. Yeah, I've been on YouTube for a long time. I've been on YouTube since day one. USGS will probably come in and change the depth of these earthquakes. Currently, they have them all at 10 kilometers. But with finite earthquakes, generally because they're on so many different faults within that area, they're at different depths. So they'll probably come in later and change them all. They got them at 10 kilometers, which is about 6.2 miles below sea level. USGS puts all the depth of the earthquakes in kilometers. See, they got them all for 10 kilometers. Yeah, if there was a huge tsunami, New Caledonia would have been wiped out. They are so lucky. And the tsunami would have wrapped around and, would have hit Fiji Islands, etc. It could have gone as far as Australia. The New Hebrides Trench is one of the deepest trenches in the area, over 25,000 feet or 6,200 meters. The area where this earthquake occurred is what they call the Hunter Fracture Zone, which can be traced all the way up to Fiji. See that line, the ridge? That's why I'm saying that's going to be the next area probably to have a large earthquake. It also extends up to Vanuatu. And I'll bring that up. See that? So more than likely, these earthquakes are going to continue for a very long time. Look how long they've been continuing there along Challis, Idaho, or around Challis, Idaho. That's part of the Walker Lane Fault Zone. That's a new fault zone that's eventually going to overtake and be prominent. No longer would the San Andreas Fault Zone be prominent, but that's going to be a long time in the future. Originally, USGS said that that earthquake was 10 kilometers in depth, which they changed, and they also changed the location. There's the original location, and then they changed it to 12.1 kilometers in depth later on down the road. All very interesting that it's going to change the movement of many of these faults in this location. Yeah, what's going to happen in the future? Time will tell. Definitely send our prayers to all those people over there. What are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm also on Patreon, and I'm also on Twitter. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.